Today, we 3D print a set of organic-shaped vent covers. Last weekend, we modified and assembled these IKEA wardrobes. As they are placed against an exterior wall, the base needs vent holes so that air can circulate and we don't get any mold behind them. When we build our living cell table, we use the Voronoi pattern for the design. Having a few vent holes with different patterns could be an interesting design feature. On GitHub, Felipe Sanchez offers a library that generates Voronoi patterns in OpenScad. If you are not interested in the geeky OpenScad design, feel free to skip forward to the end of the green bar you see at the bottom of the screen. To get started, we copy the example from the library and play around with it. The pattern is created as a 2D shape, so we have to use the linear extrude command to convert it into a 3D shape. As we're actually not interested in the pattern itself, but in the connecting lines, we define two new variables for the opening of the vent hole and the thickness of the cover. We then create the difference between a cylinder of that size and the Voronoi pattern. This doesn't look very compelling, so we change some of the parameters, in particular the area in which the segments are created, the center of the pattern, and make sure that the nuclei are not displayed. After modifying the pattern a bit so that it fully overlaps the cylinder, we get a nice mesh. We then create a border around the mesh to increase its stability. We define a new variable for the width of the border and create a frame as the difference of two cylinders. We combine the patterns and the frame as one object by using the union command. Now we have a disc with an interesting pattern. With two additional cylinders, we create a tube that is a little longer than the material in which the vent hole is cut, 18 mm in our case. The tube is added to the disc. As we don't want to glue the vent covers in the holes, we subtract two shallow cubes so that the cylinder can be bent inwards. Lastly, we create a small rim at the top for the cover to snap in place. You can download the file from my website or Thingiverse. While you could customize your vent cover on Thingiverse itself, I suggest you download the free OpenScad application as it will allow you to try out different versions quite quickly. After adjusting the vent size and the material thickness to your needs, you will notice that the pattern of the vent cover is changing every time you save the file. Once you found a pattern you like, go to the text window at the lower right and copy the value for seed that is displayed there. Then replace the undef in the editor on the left-hand side by that value. Now click the hourglass icon to render the file and save it as an STL file. We use Cura to slice the model. If the model is oriented with the pattern on the build plate, no supports are needed. We create a couple of covers by repeating this process. On the final prints, we spray automotive primer, sand it down, and repeat the process until the surface is a bit smoother. The vent gets two coats of spray lacquer and is ready to be installed. We mark a set of four holes with the divider and drill 40 mm holes in the baseboard using a force nut drill. We then install the vent covers and mount the base to the front of the wardrobe. This project is a nice showcase for the power of a programmatic modeling approach such as OpenScad. If you want to keep up with new projects on 3D printing, woodworking, laser cutting and more, please subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram for a look at future projects.